So today we're going to make a DIY circuit to control a spot welder. Stick around. As you saw in my last video, I put together a DIY spot welder using lithium polymer cells, also a DIY circuit board that I designed. And today we're gonna take that same board that you saw in the last video, and we're gonna put it in a permanent circuit like this. This is something that I'm gonna do to leave it here in battery hookup, and then we're gonna start doing the design for a more detailed and permanent circuit board that we're gonna order. And hopefully you get to use that for your DIY projects. Now, this whole idea comes from the need that it's out there for you to build better and faster battery packs. So with that in mind, we were trying to build a spot welder that could be used to do nickel and fusing. And most of the time, it's not possible, especially with the different materials that you have in your house. So this video is only to build the circuit board, and it's not going to be based on building the battery, because, you know, I'm just putting together two lithium polymer batteries together in parallel and then using that to output probably 400 up to 900 amps in just a glimpse of a second. So it's going to be a long one, but hopefully you're going to like it. Stick around. So for this DIY circuit, we're gonna use a relay. This is just a 12 volt relay, and I actually salvaged this from a PCB board that Tom from Battery Hookup has laying around. We're gonna use a typical proto board. This is used to do more permanent circuits. So we're gonna use two push buttons like this one. I'm also gonna use three 10 microfarad capacitors. This is another piece that we're gonna use. It is not a must have, but it's a nice to have. It's just. So this is how my setup goes. I got a positive that will go to the solenoid over here. And I got a negative that will go to my negative over here on the battery, but also gets, right now it's this circuit, it's open over here, and when I trigger the relay, it's gonna allow the full 12 volts go to the solenoid, which allows the whole voltage and amperage go from the LiPo battery. Basically, it's all connected together. I'm gonna use this switch right here, the push button, to charge the little cap, and this one's to discharge those little caps and trigger the whole system. What we're looking for this test is to hear a loud click, just like that. Basically, it means that when I'm making the connections over here, I'm also connecting this. And as you can hear, let me just get you closer. That sound, it's basically the solenoid just connecting together. So there you go, a DIY circuit to trigger a spot welder and have a specific amount of time to not burn the cells and stuff like that. We are still testing this, but it is possible. I know I talked to some of you and said that these batteries are quite too large for something like this. We already tested this with a 3S, 1P using lithium polymer batteries, and believe me, they are way too powerful for something like that. But using two cells in parallel, it's more than enough to spot weld a battery like this. So now you have a better idea on how to create a circuit board. And in the future videos, I would go step by step on how to design it. And also, I will teach you what software I use to make my diagram. In the meantime, just remember this video is sponsored by Battery Hookup. And hope you guys like it. There's gonna be links below if you wanna visit the store of Battery Hookup on eBay. And just to let you know, there's a website coming. Just pay attention to the videos. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. And also like and share, because that's what helps me. God bless you all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.